Today, we're going to get the engine put in and a few other little things. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Frank and Carrie's Homestead. We're working on the model again. Sorry about being away for a few days. Been having some health problems. Passing kidney stones. Feel a lot better today. So let's get putting the motor in. Check the brew tip. Make sure it's not plugged. Which it is. I'll set it aside, clean it later. Put a new tip on. Get your glue. Put your little dab of glue. Motor mounts. Same way back here on your transmission. Now this one is a little tricky because of the exhaust. They don't really give you enough room. Member, they'll let you set that in there. The easiest way for me to do this is I'm going to actually cut this out and then I'll glue it back in just because of the way they molded it. Why they do that, I have no idea. You can see there's no room to get that exhaust underneath. Let me try something here. Sometimes this can work. Let's just give it a little bit of pressure and try to slide at the same time. See me doing this, but there we go. Just about there. Okay, we wait. Actually got it in. Shaft in, which this can also be tricky. Everybody has their troubles. Got the motor in. Now, we can actually set this interior in. First, I set it in. Make sure everything looks good. The first step before that is, you gotta put the firewall on. This piece right here. Gotta put the firewall in. I like putting glue about anywhere it's gonna be touching on here. Let it set for a second. Get the glue in here. Set it in there, get it lined up. Like that. Okay. Alright, now we gotta let that dry. And then we can move on. Putting in your radiator and everything like that. Your radiator hoses. But after this dries, then I'll get back to you and we'll do some more. But after it dries, I gotta go through and check, make sure I don't need to touch up any paint anywhere, anything like that. So we'll get back to you. Okay, on your little glue tips, they happen to get plugged. I always just keep a little piece of wire like that. You're not out buying them all the time. Just keep a piece of wire around, just stick it up through. Stick it up through there, and you'll get all your unused glue out of it. I'll run it through a couple times, make sure it's clear. You don't need to be out buying a bunch of new tips. Anywhere at it, clean them yourself. Now, this model right here, the Reveal Street Burner, it's a level 2 model, 1/25 scale. It is not the best built kit. That's why it's a level 2. This model, if you plan on getting it, don't count on it being the best model, because it's definitely not. There's a lot of little tedious things you have to do. One of the problems I ran into, I'll show you in just a second. Where your wheels mount, in here, they're not the best. So when you glue them, you gotta make sure you support them any way you can to keep them straight. There's a lid, they have a real small tab that goes into the wheel, and actually your modeling glue will melt it enough, because it's melting itself to the plastic. What your modeling glue does is it kind of melts the plastic, so you're going plastic to plastic. Well, it melts it just enough that it deforms it. So you have to really be careful and make sure you support it and everything so it, your wheels don't go one way or the other. I found that out after I glued the wheels on from the last video, and I had to support it to get it straight. So remember that. We'll catch you on the next video. Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe if you like model building for this. But always, smile today, smile tomorrow, you're gonna smile all week. Guaranteed. Here's some suggested videos for you. While you're here, why don't you check out some of these other videos that's gonna be right up here, right in this area over here somewhere. Just watch it for in this area over here. Okay? Make sure you watch them. like them. Bye.